No disrespect to your honor.
Janowski could help you, or what you thought she could tell me, but I can tell you, I have never, ever held an attorney. I think I can tell you, I've never held an attorney in contempt of court.
Your honor?
In all my years. And so let me tell you, I was late. We were late with the criminal calendar. I mean, the criminal calendar went until when, April?
At 11 o'clock.
We had a first-degree murder sentencing where we had so quite frankly, we were running late. So 45 minutes, and plus you made a phone call. That's all I require. I got the phone call, I knew it, and I have never, ever held an attorney in contempt of court, and I certainly have never in my entire career held an attorney in contempt of court for being late. Never.
Your Honor,
I don't believe anybody told you that.
I've only been licensed in Nevada since 2003, and I'm operating from what other people have told me. I have nothing but the utmost respect for Your Honor, and I believe Your Honor when you said you never held anyone in contempt.
Never.
And call it.
I didn't say anybody.
Call it fear of the unknown, Judge. But and my experience with you has been nothing but positive. And I was a little bit nervous, and I asked this young lady to accompany me, and that was the reason I asked her to come with me. She's not an ex-girlfriend, she's a friend of a friend, and I apologize for misrepresenting that to the judge, and
who were you talking to back in chambers? I mean, the nurse left and we couldn't get you off your cell phone.
I was talking to my girlfriend, my fiance.
Oh, your real girlfriend.
My fiance.
Okay.
Judge, I don't want to make this a soap opera, and I apologize.
Well, you have.
I know.
I've never seen anything like this in my entire life.
You've turned it
into a soap opera.
Judge, I'm a trial attorney. I've been in the business for 16 years. I've done 67 jury trials, and I feel terrible about this.
Okay, now, again, I just want to make sure, where's your car now?
My car is...
There's three cars involved in this accident. Not one person called the police.
Correct.
Okay? So somebody hit you, that was a hit and run, you didn't call the police, and none of the other two people that were involved in the accident called the police. So three vehicles were involved in an accident at Rancho and Sahara.
Mm-hmm.
You told me you left your house at 9 o'clock.
Yes, ma'am.
Although you said you didn't wake up till 9:30. So I'm not quite sure when you left your house. But just tell me the major crossroads of your house.
I want to restate that I woke up at 9:25. I left my house at 10 o'clock, and I was hit at approximately 10:15. My car was not drivable. A good Samaritan helped me push my car to Rancho between Sahara and I guess it's. I'm not sure if it's Twain. I'm not sure what's
Rancho and Sahara intersect, so you told me back in chambers that you were going northbound on Rancho.
Yes, ma'am.
That you made a left to go eastbound on Sahara, and that your car was pushed over into the right lane.
Yes, ma'am.
You told me it was in the lane, but I'm assuming you got
it out of... It was in the right lane, and someone came and actually pushed me into the turning lane.
And you have a black Audi.
Gray, Your Honor.
I'm sorry. A gray Audi.
A Las Vegas Centennial plate.
Okay.
Judge, if I can just start.
Sure.
If we can make the record. First of all, when Mr. Camango came in, I was in the courtroom along with the COs and Officer Vargas, who has just told Your Honor what he believed he heard. And that's also what I believed I heard, is Mr. Camango say, I called the cops and I had to wait for 2 hours. And then they joked about it, about cops not showing up for 2 hours. That was my recollection of the conversation. Judge, additionally, I also heard Mr. Camango said it was a black Audi, that he was severely rear-ended, that it was on pushed off to the side of the road on Sahara. He got a ride from a Good Samaritan and came to the courthouse where he called his ex-girlfriend to come here for support. That ex-girlfriend's name was Christine.
I know, but now it turns out Christine is really Josephine.
Correct. Judge, he's given us several different time frames of when he got up, when he left, when the accident was. Judge, I can tell you that the follow-up we have done, we have called Detective Vaughn, who was a detective in this case, who was in that area at this time. And Mr. Tomczak has actually talked to Detective Vaughn so he can make those representations.
Judge, as prosecutors, we obviously have an obligation to protect the record and protect this proceeding before Your Honor, and that's why we've taken the steps that we have, because we had representations from counsel this morning that he was prepared to proceed with trial.
Regardless of his injuries.
Right. My observations were observing him that there was clearly something wrong with him. I noticed he was slurring his speech. I noticed he seemed unsteady on his feet. And when actually Mr. Caramano came back into the courtroom, he seemed very unsteady on his feet as he walked by and actually ran into our counsel table. So those concerns, I mean, above and beyond what we've already talked about in here, we wanted to follow up and see if we could maybe shed some light on what actually happened and what his injuries may or may not be. Detective Vaughn is the detective in this case who is scheduled to testify at 1:30 this afternoon. I called him to let him know that we wouldn't need him because we were running behind schedule, and I spoke to him briefly, and he told me he was eating lunch in the area of Sahara and Decatur. So I said, hey, while you're out there, do me a favor. Can you run by on Sahara and see if you see this vehicle? And in fact, he went, drove up and down Sahara, didn't see the vehicle. I told him it was in the neighborhood of Rancho.
Didn't see the vehicle?
Not on Sahara. He turned onto Rancho and actually saw the vehicle on Rancho, not on Sahara, as Mr. Caramagno stated back in Chambers.
It's on Rancho. I said it was on Rancho.
And I certainly don't want to, I'm not trying to throw any dirt on Mr. Caramagno. I'm just telling the court what our understanding of this is. Detective Vaughn ran the plates on the vehicle. It does come back to a 2006 Audi. There's no rear end damage in the car, but there is front end damage. And the car is registered to an individual named Christopher Ponto. And Chris is the name that was given, that Mr. Caramano was given as the Good Samaritan that drove him back to court. What all that means, I do not know.
Well, the 2006, there is a 2006 Audi.
There's a 2006 Rancho. Audi on Rancho, north of Eastern, or north of Sahara.
On Rancho.
With.
Pardon?
On Rancho.
With front end damage.
And it comes back to who?
Christopher Ponto.
And Your Honor, I can explain that as well.
Well, I hope so, because you told me you were in your car. You told me you were in your, you used a term that I asked you to, my drive car.
It's my daily driver, Your Honor.
Yeah, daily driver is what you used.
No, daily driver. I had a client named Christopher Ponto. My best friend is a gentleman named Victor Ponto. His son was incarcerated in the state penitentiary. I represented him. He had a car lease. I assumed the lease from Christopher Ponto, and I've been making the payments for him. The car is insured. It's registered. It's still in the name of Christopher Ponto, and I've been driving it, Your Honor. I've been making the payments, and it's still registered to Christopher Ponto. And
Christopher Ponto is in prison.
He's incarcerated, Your Honor.
And that was in Clark County?
Yes, Your Honor.
Where, who did you appear in front of?
Your Honor, the
that
case
person.
Was originally
is it P-A-N-T-O?
It was in front of Judge Wall, Your Honor.
P-O-N-T-O?
P-O-N-T-O, Your Honor. And Mr. Ponto had leased the car for his girlfriend, who was the complaining witness in the case. He received a 12 to 40. I assume the lease on Mr. Ponto's car. I've been making the payments. I have the insurance in my name, and that's my daily driver. So the car was hit from behind. There's minimal damage in the back. There's substantial damage in the front. And it sits right now on Rancho on the side.